to travel. Have you ever dreamed of travelling the country in a camper van? Or maybe you have a motorhome sitting in your driveway that you hardly ever use. Well, our travel journalist, Debbie Griffiths, has the solution for both. Morning, Debbie.
Good morning, Mel.
So you travelled with MyWay before, but explain how it works.
Okay, well, this is a super easy way to have that classic Kiwi road trip experience. So if you haven't heard of it before, think of MyWay as the Airbnb of RVs. So it's a sharing platform that links motorhome owners with travellers through the MyWay.com website. So it might sound a little impersonal, but once you are connected with the owners, it becomes this really warm and welcoming experience, as you can see. So this was our first time meeting Yvonne and Kevin, and they are absolutely lovely. And once again, as we were last time, we were offered coffee and then spent an hour with them learning all about their camper van. So the camper van we hired was really well kitted out with an awning and two TVs, chairs, double bed above the cab, two single beds that can transform from lounge to couches to become a super king if needed. So it's really easy to drive as well. This is my second time driving a camper van, so it was really easy. And the great thing that Kevin and Yvonne have done is they've added some solar panels to the top of their camper, so we always had power wherever we went.
That's awesome. It looks like MyWay owners are actually really great ambassadors for the brand.
Yeah, and for New Zealand as a whole as well. So Kevin and Yvonne had some really cool ideas for the area that we were travelling to, where to go, what to see, and even practical day-to-day stuff like where the dump stations are for keeping the camper clean. And because they use the camper, they travel in it, it's set up with everything you need for a really comfortable holiday away.
Yeah, people have put some thought into it. Mm. So where did you go?
Well, we headed to the gorgeous Eastern Bay of Plenty. Now, I actually used to live in Whakatane, but I've never spent time in and around Opotiki. So we were hosted by Jim and Kenny from Mighty Motu Bike Tours. They took us on the Dunes Trail, which runs behind the beach, just east of Opotiki. So from town, you head over the Pakowhai Ki Otu Taupuku Bridge over the Otara River, and then you follow the 10-kilometre long trail behind the beach. So it's a really gently undulating track, as you can see there. Really well maintained and a good metre wide, so really easy to cycle together or make way for other people on the path. As you can see, lookout spots, picnic spots along the way, great beach access. And it's a really wide, long stretch of sand, so it never feels crowded, ever.
Awesome. So it's good for all levels of fitness?
Yeah, so listed as a grade 2, so a nice, easy, enjoyable ride for a family. And it runs adjacent to the Pacific Ocean, so you can always see or hear the ocean. And look, if you want to relax and let someone else do the thinking for you, contact Kenny at Mighty Motu Bike Tours. He can arrange a bike tour. So there are other trails in the area that vary in difficulty. The Pakihi track is in the hills behind Opotiki, and it's for more experienced riders, and it's also a really gorgeous track that runs alongside a river to hike with the family. So you can see it there, it is absolutely gorgeous, very easy for me and my 10-year-old. Another easy bike ride is out to Hukataya Domain, where you can visit the 2,000-year-old Puriri tree, where Māori remains were found 100 years ago. So the domain is a gorgeous 4.5-hectare pocket of native bush, well worth a visit for all its huge historical and botanical value.
It's really gorgeous. And you went jet boating as well.
Yeah, so as soon as you catch sight of the Motu River, you'll be stunned. It is absolutely gorgeous. So contact Mark Looney at Motu River Jet. He's a local, he's been operating for about 4 years, so he really knows and loves this river. So the Motu River was the very first in New Zealand to be completely protected by the government conservation order. So it's a really great opportunity to see some of our most pristine native forests in one of the most remote parts of the country. So you get a 1.5-hour experience that'll take you about 18 k's up the river and back. And not only do you get a really fun, safe, exhilarating jet boat ride up the Motu, you'll get a couple of stops because Mark has done his homework. He has discovered all of the secret places that are not on the map. He'll tell you about the geography and the history in the area, including this tunnel. It's about 100 metres long. And it was actually part of an abandoned hydroelectricity scheme. So he's done the research, how it was made. Oh, yes, he's named those wetters.
Yeah, wetters.
Well. No. He knows all the secret waterfalls, all the best places to go for a dip if you visit there in summer. So this area is absolutely stunning. It kind of reminded me of Fiordland. You see the mountains kind of dipping down to the river, so there's a lot of forestry land there, but also plenty of untouched native bush there as well.
That's really beautiful. Are there other options as well?
Yeah, well, if you want to get dropped off up the river to go fishing or camping, Mark is really happy to work with you to make that happen. If you're visiting over summer, book well in advance. Mark's jet boat tours are super popular and they book up really fast.
So are there some good places to eat too?
Yes. Okay, so the Royal Aporiki has beautiful gourmet meals created by Chef Ryan Willis. He's an Aporiki local who's spent time on Gold Coast.
Check
Isn't
that out.
Gorgeous?
Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So right next door to the Royal, the Two Fish Cafe has just been taken over by some new owners, Guillaume and Chloe. They've got a really lovely range of cabinet food as well as burgers as well.
Oh, they look nice.
It's Guillaume right there. And Te Kaha Beach Resort, it sits on a cliff top overlooking the ocean and is a really great place to eat. Each cafe and restaurant was really happy to whip up a vegan option for me as well.
Excellent, that's right, because you are a vegan.
Yes.
So where did you stay?
So we stayed at Ohiwa Beach Holiday Park. So it's got a playground and a bouncing pillow. And we went on an evening walk to see glowworms there. Right on the beach, there's the bouncing pillow. Always a good fun. And the view from the top of the hill next door, yeah, it is stunning. Then we drove past Aporiki to Marae Hako Campground. So this one is right on the beach, no power here, but pahutukawa trees lining the beach for that quintessentially Kiwi camping experience. Yeah, that was super fun. It was absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, that looks beautiful. And so it sounds like My Way made the whole trip really easy for you.
Yeah, absolutely. So go on to the myway.com website. You just select where you'd like to pick up from, the type of vehicle, and My Way connects you with the owners who are all over the country. Have a blast.
Excellent stuff. Hey, Debbie, thank you so much. That
no
trip looked incredible. It's a great time, too, actually, to start planning your summer holiday road trip. Well, if you haven't planned already, visit myway.com. And, of course, if you have a camper and you want to start making a bit of extra money on those days, it's just sitting in the driveway, then you can list the vehicle there, too.